Hi guys, it's Michelle. Welcome back to my channel. If you've been here before, if you're new, then thanks for tuning in. So this is just a very quick wig review for you guys. And the wig that I'm wanting to review is the one that I'm wearing just now, which is new for 2019. And it's part of the Send to Lotus collection. This is called Aster. And the shade that I'm wearing, the colour code for this is L838690R. It is very, very cute. And the shade name for that is Oak Melange Rooted. So this is part of the Send to Lotus collection. Send to are one of the brands from Aderyn's. And honestly, this collection is just beautiful. This is standard synthetic hair. The cap on this is really, really beautiful. As you guys can see, this is a bob style. So let me just give you some of the lengths and the specs here, and then can talk a wee bit more about this. Okay, so synthetic fibre. This is said to be an average size of cap, but in honesty to me this feels quite similar to the sizing on the Jasmine wig from Send to Lotus. It is meant to be comparable to the Hazel. Personally, I feel this is definitely on the smaller side. I am kind of ultra petite head. To me, this is, it's a good fit on me. So I think if you are just an average size, it may not be great for you, but there is a bit of stretch to it. Anyway, it is beautiful. It is a lovely, lovely cap, especially if you're total hair loss. Now, the length on this, the fringe bang area at the front, we have 4 inches of length at the very front here. There are 4 inches at the nape as well, but from the crown we've got 10.2 inches from the very, very crown top here. It is just a very classic style of bob with this kind of shorter fringe. Now, the cap construction allows for so much versatility with this style. It's really, really beautiful. Now, what we do have on this is a full ear-to-ear lace front. So what I'm going to do just now, if I bring these hairs back, you can have a look and you can see it does look like those hairs are coming from your own scalp, and that is right around the front to allow for off-the-face styling. Now, what you can do, up to yourself, if you like to have a full fringe, you can obviously have this cut to a full fringe. You can obviously wear it kind of split depending on what your parting is. You can wear it purely all over to the side. Now, we do have a full monofilament top on this wig, and the thing that's lovely about a full monofilament top is that it allows you to change that parting up. You can go left, you can go right, you can go centre, just whatever it is your own kind of personal preference. Another thing you can do if you like to have some off the face styling, but you still want the length around your face, what you can do is that kind of fringe bang area, you can bring that back, and you could obviously use a little clip or something to hold that fringe back. And because you have this beautiful natural lace front, then it does look incredibly natural. For me, I tend not to go for this so much as I would maybe add a braid, a kind of French braid into the front and pull it to the side if I wanted. Now, we have a fully hand-tied cap, and I'm going to take it off to show you the cap from the inside. There are a couple of things with this that's just so beautiful. So we have this welded lace front that runs, as we said, from ear tab to ear tab. You will notice that these ear tabs are silicone coated, and there are metal stays inside to allow you to bend and conform it to the shape of your head. We have a single monofilament top section here, which allows for your multi-directional parting. Now, we have this kind of tulle material, hand tied for the sides and the back. The very nape does have some wefts, but they are enclosed. Now, for me personally, it is a matter of personal preference, but to me, if a wig does have wefts, I do prefer closed wefting to open. I feel it's more comfortable in my scalp and it's not as problematic for me with my sensitive skin. So I do like the fact that if there are going to be wefts, that they have closed these over. I like that a lot. I find it cooler. Now, we have this kind of extended felt nape here, and what you might notice is a bit of shininess. That is because we have this silicone running along the bottom here. Now, that is just to allow for some grip, so that your wig's not sliding around. It's very, very nice. I love having that on wigs. Now, we have these Velcro adjusters that stick onto this kind of velvet coated felt nape that we have here. Now, normally I do have to bring all of my circumference measurements in on a wig. However, with this one, I don't actually really have to do that because this is a smaller size of cap. I certainly feel it is smaller. It's so, so beautiful. Now, let me just show you the rooting here. It's quite a natural root that we have. It's not too dark. It's quite an ashy, darkest blonde, lightest brown, and then we have these kind of yellowy blonde tones. This does come in so many different shades, so you can have your choice of colour. The colours that I have seen on the Lotus collection are all very beautiful, extremely natural, but you also have some nice new fashion shades that have been launched 2019 this year. I wanted to show that obviously you can wear this absolutely sleek and very nice, and just how she kind of comes. Now, what I have here in my hand, I have a wee bit of flexible spray gel for synthetic wigs, and I have a little contour cream for synthetic wigs as well. I would maybe use a bit of the gel if I was wanting to have it super duper sleek. What I'm actually doing just now is just taking too much, but a tiny, tiny smidgen of cream, contour cream, and I am rubbing that between my fingers. And this is a great product if you like, even if you just like to kind of piece out your fringe slightly so it's more structured, if you're looking to just add a wee bit of volume, whether it's in at the roots. I love this specific cream because it actually, with the wide tooth comb, comes out as easily as it goes in, and it doesn't leave a kind of residue. I'm not a fan of things that leave residue on my wigs, so I don't want to have to wash it every time I've used a tiny bit of styling product. So, you know, you can play around with that. You can use that just on the ends to kind of have them. I mean, this is synthetic, but obviously you're just seeing, I am literally a tiny bit, not that I would say have it like poker straight, but if you want to have the ends kind of poker straight, this cream even works brilliantly. This is a lovely style because you can have it more modern, more kind of funky, more edgy. You can have some poker straight sections. You can literally, you could piece it out and have some of it kind of flipping out the way like this. I actually think that looks really nice as well, and the contour cream is just allowing me to kind of flip that out the way, and it will hold nicely without kind of permanently changing it. It is just literally holding those wee layers flipped outwards, which can be more modern, and it's just so pretty. I mean, I quite like this kind of look. I like a whole variety of looks, just depending on what mood I'm in, and that's what I love with wigs that have some versatility. I like to have the ability to be able to change how it looks, to have it more looking poker straight, or to be able to kind of flip it out, and to be able to then just wear it sleek and turned under, and just kind of like, when I had hair, I didn't always have my hair sitting perfect. Some days my hair would flip out and I wouldn't necessarily want it to do that, but that's what I love. I love when wigs can be manipulated to look that way because it's very natural and it's what biological hair would do. So, you know, for me this is beautiful. Aster is a very easy day-to-day style, you know, it's very easy to wear. She's comfortable, she's lightweight, she is very good quality. The base materials are good quality, the hair fibres are lovely. You know, I am loving the cap construction on this. This is a lovely blonde. It's not necessarily a blonde I would specifically have chosen, but the beautiful team at Trendsco have sent me this for the purposes of doing a bit of a review, and I love when, you know, I love when I get to choose colours, but I also love when I'm surprised with beautiful colours because it does let me see different things that are out there. Now, what some people will want to know is this long enough to be tied back if, say, you wanted to do a ponytail? So I have a bit of bobble here. Now, this length, the fringe is obviously shorter, so I am kind of side sweeping it, and I would just kind of split it so this side's going one way, this side's going the other. It's up to you, but I would tend to just bring a wee bit down here around my face, but you can tie it all back. It's going to be a tiny ponytail that you have, but if you do like to have the option of having a ponytail, then yes, you can absolutely achieve that. You can achieve that. It's very, very lovely. I probably won't cut any more of a fringe on this. I am happy with it as she is. I have some of a side fringe, but I have the ability to mess around and play with it, and I'll probably just leave it as is. I hope that will be good for you. So take care, keep sparkling, be your own beautiful. I'll be back soon with more wig reviews, more chat, more life stuff. You know how it is. But till next time, look after yourselves. Bye guys. Bye. Mwah.